Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the previous class we were doing the chapter subtraction, correct? So we saw what is subtraction. What is subtraction? Subtraction means to take away. So we always subtract a smaller number from a larger number. So always we subtract a smaller number from a larger number. Also, the result of a subtraction is called as difference. The result you get when you subtract two numbers, it is called as difference. Okay, and subtraction is signified by the minus sign. So then we saw how to do subtraction on number line. So we count backwards on a number line to subtract two numbers. Right? Then we did the next topic, which was subtraction without regrouping. So how do you do subtraction without regrouping? So we have seen subtraction of two-digit numbers. You will know how to do subtraction of two-digit numbers in first line. So how do you do it? So here they have told subtract 14 from 56. So here they have drawn 56 blocks. That is 5 tens and 6 ones. Correct? And from that, they have striked out 14. So 14 means 1 ten and 4 ones. So we will strike out 1 ten and then we strike out 4 ones like this. So how many blocks are left? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 tens left and 1, 2 ones left. So 4 tens and 2 ones. So 56 minus 14 is 42. Right? So the difference is 42 over here. So this, then we saw a few examples on how to do it. Correct? So let's do it again just for revision. So here we have 56 minus 35. So how do you do 56 minus 35? Now we have 56 blocks. From that we'll strike out 35 blocks. So first 35, so 3 tens. So we'll strike out 3 tens like this. So 1, 2 and 3. So now how many tens are left here? 2 tens are left. So we'll write 2 tens. Then we'll strike out 5 ones. So 1, this is 2. 3, 4 and 5. So how many 1s are left? We are left with 1, 1. So what is it? 2 tens and 1, 1 makes 21. So 56 minus 35 is 21. Then here we have 69 minus 45. So from the 69 blocks, we have to strike out 45 blocks. So first we have 45. So 4 tens are there. So we'll strike out 4 tens. So this is 1. 2, 3 and this is 4. So we strike out 4 tens. So how many tens are left here? We are left with 2 tens. Now we have to strike out 5 ones. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So how many ones we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2 tens and 4 ones. So 2 tens and 4 ones make which number? It makes 24. So 69 minus 45 is 24. Okay, so this is how you do subtraction without regrouping. Now to moving on to the next topic, that is today's topic, subtraction with regrouping. So what we did was subtraction without regrouping. Now when we did addition, you all remember we changed the ones into tens. So when we add two numbers and when we were adding ones, we saw that the number was exceeding 9. For example, 6 plus 5 is 11. So 11 is more than 9. So we can't write 11 in ones place. So what we'll do, we'll regroup 11 ones as 1 10 and 1 ones. So we did regrouping, and that is carrying over. So we carry over the 1 10 to tens place and keep 1 ones in ones place. So we did carrying over in addition. Now in subtraction, what you do in sometimes what happens, you cannot subtract two numbers. Okay, you know that you have to always subtract a smaller number from a larger number. You cannot subtract a larger a larger number from a smaller number. Okay, so what you do at such times, we change tens into ones. In addition, we change ones into tens. In subtraction, we change tens into ones. So in addition, we call the regrouping as carrying over. In subtraction, we call the regrouping as borrowing. Okay, for example, you have I'm asking you to give me 5 pencils. Okay, but you don't have any pencils with you. So what you'll do, you'll borrow 5 pencils from someone and then give it to me. When you don't have pencils with you, you cannot give it to me, correct? So what you do, you borrow 5 pencils from somebody else, from your next from the next person, and then give it to me. So that is called borrowing. Okay, so in subtraction, regrouping is called as borrowing. Now first we'll study subtraction of 1-digit number from a 2-digit number with borrowing. So how do you do it? Now here they have told from 27 marbles remove 8 marbles. So how many are left? So 27 minus 8. So normally when what you all will do, normally you will just strike out 8 marbles and then count how many marbles are left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now how many if you have to count, how will you count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So if you go on counting, it is counting, it could be a long procedure. Okay, even though 27 minus 8 is equal to 19 is correct, but it will be very long. So what is the alternate method? Alternate method is this. So step 1, now first what you do, you write 27 in columns like this. So 2 tens and 7 ones. So tens and ones. Minus 8. So 8 will write in ones column. So first you always write the larger number and then the smaller number. So the larger number here is 27 and the smaller number is 8. Okay, then we subtract the ones column. So in ones column, I have 7 and 8. So that is 7 ones minus 8 ones. But here 8 is greater than 7. So we cannot subtract 8 ones from 7 ones. Okay, we cannot subtract 8 ones from 7 ones. So what we'll do? If we can only subtract a smaller number from a greater number, but we cannot subtract a greater number from a smaller number. So what I'll do is I'll borrow 1 from 10. Okay, so I'll borrow 1 10 or 10 ones. So when I borrow, in tens place I have 2, correct? In tens place I have 2. So when I borrow 1 from this 2, this 2 becomes 1, that is it becomes 1 less. So 2 minus 1 is 1. So 1 remains in tens place and the other 1 we take it over to ones place. So that is 10 ones. So 7 becomes 17. Okay, so borrow 1 10 from the tens column. So 7 ones plus 1 10 becomes 17 ones. Now we can subtract the ones column because 17 is greater than 8. So how much is 17 minus 8? 17 minus 8 is 9 ones. Okay, now in tens column, the 2 tens minus 1 10 because we borrowed 1 10 becomes 1 10. Okay, so that 1, and in tens place for the second number there is nothing, so 1 that you can consider it as 0. So 1 minus 0, 1. So 19. So 27 minus 8 is 19. Right, so let's see 2 more examples on subtraction with regrouping. So here they have told subtract 43 minus 26. Okay, so here we have 43 blocks. And now 43 minus 26. In ones place we have 3 minus 6. We cannot do 3 minus 6. What we'll do, we'll borrow 1 from the tens place. So this 4, what it is? When I'm borrowing 1, it becomes 4 minus 1, 3. So in tens place I have 3 left. And this 3 becomes 13 ones. So how much is 13 minus 6? 13 minus 6 is 7. Okay, and 3 minus 2 here. How much is 3 minus 2? 3 minus 2 is 1. So that is 17. Okay. So we cannot take away 6 ones from 3 ones. So we borrow 1 10 from the tens column and change it into 10 ones. These ones are added to the 3 ones already there. So to get 13. So now here you see 43 blocks are there. And I can't subtract 26 from 6 from 3. So what I'll do, this 1 10 that is there, I'll break it into 1s. So that becomes 10 1s here. As you see, we have 13 1s total, 3 10s and 13 ones. Now from this 13 ones, I'll remove 6 ones. So how many ones are left? 7 ones. Okay, so I have left 3 tens and 7 ones. Okay, but in tens place, the 4 tens has become 3 tens because we borrowed one from it. So we got, so we have to subtract 3 minus 2. So if I take out 2 tens, I'll be left with 1 ten. So the answer is 17. Okay, so this is how you do subtraction without regrouping. Now let's see a few problems which are there in your textbook. Okay, so before we solve the exercise, let's do this. So here they have told regroup 110 and subtract 24 minus 8. So here what you'll do, first you will, now here we have 24, right? So 2 tens and 4 ones. So 4 minus 8, so 4 ones minus 8 ones we cannot do. So this 110, what is there? You change it to 10 ones. So we get 14 ones. Okay, we get 14 ones. So how much is 14 minus 8? 14 minus 8 is 6. So we'll write 6 here. And then this 2 tens, when we take out this 110 from 2 tens, it becomes 1. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So 16. So you have to draw the blocks here properly. You have to draw one tower like this of 110. And then 14 in one block. So 14 blocks you have to draw. Okay, and then strike out and show how to do the calculation. So draw this. Okay, draw this part for homework. Alright, so this is how you do subtraction with regrouping. Now coming to page number 117. Okay, page number 117. So let's do these problems that they've given us. Here fill in the block boxes as shown. So you have to fill those boxes. So how we'll do it? Here they have shown one example. So 5 tens plus 3 ones minus 2 tens plus 4 ones. So here 3 ones minus 4 ones. Can you do it? We can't do it. So we'll borrow one from tens place. So this became 13 ones minus 4 ones, 9 ones. And this 5 became 4. So 4 minus 2, 2. So 2 tens and 9 ones. So let's do the question here. 6 tens plus 8 ones minus 9 ones. So can you do 8 minus 9? We cannot do 8 minus 9 because 8 is smaller than 9. So we'll borrow 1 from this 6. So this 6 becomes 5. So write here in small 5. Sorry. Okay, so this 6 we borrow from 6, so 6 becomes 5. So write 5 like this here. And this 8 that is there becomes 18. Okay, it becomes 18. So write 18 like this. Okay, so 18 minus 9. So 18 ones minus 9 ones is 9 ones. So we write 9 in this box. Then 5 minus 0 is 5 only, so 5 tens. So 68 minus 9 is 5 tens plus 9 ones. Okay. So next, 9 tens plus 4 ones minus 9 ones. So 9 tens plus 4 ones minus 9 ones. So 4 ones minus 9 ones. Can you do it? We cannot do it because 4 is smaller than 9. So we'll borrow 1 from this 9. So this 9 becomes 8. So this 9 tens becomes 8 tens. And this 4 ones becomes 14 ones. So we write 14 here. So 14 ones minus 9 ones. How much is 14 minus 9? 14 minus 9 will be 6. Okay, so 14 ones minus 9 ones is 6 ones. And 8 minus 0 will be 8. So 8 tens plus 6 ones is the answer. Okay, answer is 8 tens plus 6 ones. Then the next one. 4 tens plus 7 ones minus 1 tens plus 8 ones. So 7 minus 8 ones we cannot do because 7 is smaller. So we borrow 1 from 10. So 4 becomes 3 and this 7 becomes 17. This is 1 and this is 7. So how much is 17 minus 8? 17 minus 8 is 9. Okay, 17 minus 8 is 9. So that is 9 ones. And 3 ones minus 3 tens minus 1 tens is 2 tens. So the answer is 2 tens plus 9 ones. Alright. 2 tens plus 9 ones. Now similarly do these two for homework, that is E and F. So if you're not you can't subtract, you have to borrow and do it. Okay. Then question 2. Subtract the following 15 minus 7. So how do you do 15 minus 7? Now first we'll subtract the ones. 5 ones minus 7 ones. Can you do 5 ones minus 7 ones? We cannot do it. So we'll borrow 1 from the tens place. Now in tens place we have 1. So when I borrow this 1 from the tens place, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So this becomes a 0. And this 5 ones becomes 15 ones. So how much is 15 minus 7? 15 minus 7 is 8. Okay. 15 minus 7 is 8. So that is 8 is the answer for 15 minus 7. Then 74 minus 37. Now 4 ones minus 7 ones. 4 ones is smaller than 7 ones, so we cannot subtract. So we'll borrow 110. So when I borrow 110 from 7 tens, the 7 tens become 6 tens. Okay. So it becomes 6 tens. And this 4 ones become 14 ones. So 14 ones minus 7 ones, when you do, you get 7. Okay, you get 7. 14 minus 7 is 7. Then 6 minus 3 is how much? 6 minus 3 is 3 only. Okay, so that is 37. 37. Then we have 1 minus 61 minus 24. So I can't do 1 minus 4, so I'll borrow 1 from the 6. So the 6 becomes 5 and this becomes 11. So 11 minus 4 is how much? 11 minus 4 is 7 and 5 minus 2 is 3. So 37. So 61 minus 24 is 37. Alright. Then next one, 32 minus 7. Now I can't do 2 ones minus 7 ones. So what I'll do, I'll borrow 110 from tens place. So in tens place we have 3. So that 3 becomes 2. And these 2 ones that are there become 12 ones. Okay, it becomes 12 ones. So 12 minus 7 is how much? 12 minus 7 is 5. So 12 ones minus 7 ones is 5. And then 2 minus 0 will be how much? 2 minus 0 will be 2 only. So that is 25. Okay, so this is subtraction with regrouping. These two problems, E and F, and these two problems, do it for homework. Alright, complete these questions for homework. In the next class, we will study subtraction of 3-digit numbers. Okay, we'll see subtraction of 3-digit numbers in the next class. Alright, students, I'll see you all in the next class. Thank you.